my goodness. Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of Pajodcast Legends. I'm Kyle, and today I'm going to play the most boring champion in the world. Not exactly the most boring champion in the world. The safest mid laner in the world. Playing fucking Ziggs. So Ziggs hasn't really been in the meta for a while. He did have a little bit of like a pop back in as a at the start of 2017 as a bot laner when all the AD carries were garbage, and they're like, hey, why don't we just take Ziggs? He can still take towers like nobody's business. But that was kind of like a really niche thing, and it just, it was never really something that was going to catch on big. But as a mid laner, which is his traditional role, Ziggs has not been seen in quite a while. But for those of you who were not around back then, Ziggs is like the most safe, easy to play AD carry, nope, mid laner ever. You basically just throw bombs at the wave, and that's all of the things you have to do. He's got pretty low cooldowns, 5.7 to start with, but one, you get Morello's first, really reduce those cooldowns, and also, I believe that goes down with level anyway. And that's kind of like your main thing, and everything's just really good at keeping minions away. He's also fast at taking turrets, because he can actually use his satchel charge on turrets that are low. It's just a grand old time. So basically, I'm going in against another relatively safe lane opponent, which is like the kind of like the traditional safe blind pick right now, with Ori, who's in the meta. And basically, I'm just going to sit here, farm up my waves, see what happens. I was really going to get tilted if I missed that first CS. Fucking crushing this, though. And farming's decently easy with Ziggs. Every 12 seconds, I think it is. Yeah. 12 seconds organically. There we go. Look at that. If you can't get up close, you just hit him with that goodness. He gets an empowered auto attack, and the cooldown of that goes down by using your abilities. So it becomes more often than not, Jesus, in team fights. But as of right now, I'm going to just sit here and farm it out. Play some. If Ori goes anywhere near the creep wave, I'll end up throwing bombs out to try to catch her. But until then, I'm just totally fine with just farming this out, you know? It's just super easy. Get that Thunderlord proc. I didn't get... Oh. No, it was still on cooldown from... I must have gotten it on Zac. So you kind of expect that gank to be coming in. The reason I didn't ward for it is Zac has a really... Well, one, actually, my ward wasn't back up yet. But Zac has a really easy time bypassing wards. And, oh, nice. And I have a pretty difficult time keeping up adequate vision at this point in the game. Oh, I missed the cannon. Feels bad, man. So, yeah. Pretty good start, though. Absorbed the gank. Didn't lose either summoner. Returned pretty good damage onto Ori. She's up a potion now, but, you know, what are you going to do? And now I'm going to go see if I can get a little bit of vision. Most likely place for him to come from is somewhere around this area. He's got, like, a lot of different gank options. He can come through the river if he wants to be really boring, which he actually did there, but he knew that I couldn't have had it warded yet since I had placed mine at the start of the game and they had knowledge of that. The most common place is for him to come either over this wall if I'm over too close, or back by this wall. But if he tries to make a play around here and he comes this way, I'll see him on that ward, which is why I'm very partial to that ward. We're doing a pretty good job, though. We got a nice CS lead, which is something I really don't see very often in mid lane, truthfully. I'm not usually a very good mid laner. Yeah, we're also getting very close to the first gold mark that I wanted, 900 for that lost chapter. So I'm just going to push this in super hard and go back to shop. Zac's down bot lane right now. I don't think he caught either of them on that one. There we go. And I've just gotten... Oh, that's unfortunate. And she used exhaust. That's a little bit unfortunate. Lucian flash too. Yeah, that could have been better. Jarvan might be able to turn something around here. So, yeah, my own lane's going pretty well. Top lane also... Oh, weird. I thought that Riven had participated. I guess Jarvan just soloed him out. Soloed out the Pantheon on his own. Which is totally fine. Don't think I was gonna get up there on my own otherwise, so I just figured I'd give that a little toss. And just pick up this nice farm, juicy farm. And I'm fairly certain I'm gonna hit six first, even though I've shopped and she hasn't. Nailed it. I'm pretty sure I am, but also I don't even think, even if she's got her ultimate, I don't think she has enough with just a Doran's Blade to kill me, or Doran's Ring to kill me. Oh, I thought I was going to miss that one, but, you know. It's weird that I'm on this, sitting on a 10 CS lead here, but I'm totally fine with it, and I'm pretty sure she's just gone back now, or she wants to. Give her a little how do you do. Oh my god, I'm missing. Oh, that was pretty bad. I don't know if she's completely aware of her surroundings. Now we're in a very uncomfortable position. Nice. She was totally baiting there. I'll get all this farm and say good job back. That's awesome. Okay, so now Ori's in a very uncomfortable position of trying to stop her push. Also not 100% certain, but I think that the extra damage from my Q also hits towers. My passive also does damage to towers. They might have actually removed that after they gave you the satchel, because it was like, maybe this is a bit much. Oh, I didn't get that one. Unlucky. I don't want to go for a dive here, Jarvan. I can't make that happen. Plus, Zach was right there, so that would have been a little bit on the risky side. And we've got this lovely lead that I just don't see any reason to give up. I'll just sit here and wait for the potion. And I'm going to start running down towards bot lane, because I might be able to make something happen here. I know that Ori's already en route. And I can always curve back up afterwards. Good job. They survived that gank. Didn't lose any summoners for it. And now, Ruben got pushed. Oh, Pantheon's pretty low. If I had my ulti, I would have totally gone for it. I'm going to push this in real quick. And I'm just going to go just going to walk over here. I might be able to get an ultimate off to get the job finished. But I can't be certain. Yeah, Ori's walking it in now. I don't think they know I'm here yet, though. Oh, no, they definitely do, actually. But I was able to kind of push everybody off. This is a little bit dangerous. I'm not really big on this call. Pop that so they can't get at it. I'm just going to try to keep Zach zoned off. I'm not, like, my damage is useful, but it's way better if I can just keep them from getting anywhere near this thing. Oh, I missed. Rip. Okay, so what I was trying to do there was keep them away from the pit so we could finish the Drake, because we're all pretty low and we don't really want to take this fight. I didn't realize Riven had TP'd in either. She'll probably take a little bit of this farm, but she sacrificed quite a bit to get to the fight, because Pantheon had her tower pushed in. She might actually want to stick around and see if we can get this tower before they get theirs, which actually it looks like we might be able to. They are pretty low, but probably not low enough for me to make anything happen. And I really need to hit another level so that my sweet mana regen comes in. Yeah, you get it on level ups with the last chapter, which is pretty useful this early on in the game, but it doesn't, it's not like having a finished like mana regen item or anything like that. Nailed it. gonna start waddling over this just in case there was a play to be had. There wasn't, but you know, always nice to be heads up for those things. Ziggs is not exactly much for a roaming champion, but he does have a semi-global ultimate that can kind of make things happen a little bit. Get that, yeah. And I'm 100 gold away from finishing my, what's it called? I'm actually first turret. That's the nice thing about Ziggs. I can get that tower when it's like not even close to being killable. I think it's 25% or something like that. And that that goes up as you rank up the W, although it is the last ability to skill up. I might be dead. Oh, no, okay. I was so close to flash, but I didn't... oh, no. Okay, he was coming from the wrong direction, but that's okay. Yeah, good instincts. Give me the old happiness. I'm kind of like being like a little bit of a dick suck in this game because I've been playing... so much today, like I've played a decent number of games today, and everyone's just being like gigantic toolboxes. So when everyone's being cool people, I'm inclined to give them the old reward arena. All right, we can actually probably totally turn this thing around, especially with me on my way in. I'm getting really close to range. That's a death thrash, right? Nope. Oh, so close. Now, the smart thing for us to do with me rotating down here is for Lucian to run mid when he respawns, especially because I've already taken my tower, so I can kind of just stay down here and it's not like we're losing that much pressure. He may or may not think to do that because that's a... I'm not going to say high-level play because it's not like that big of a thing, but... Plus, man, this Varus is not having a good time with me. To. That would have been the smart thing. But whatever, I'll just take the extra farm. We lose a little bit to mid tower, not that big of a deal. Pray that nobody's in this bush. Nobody's in this bush. Put this ward down for the boys. And there we go. Get all this farm. Juicy, juicy farm. And start running back down towards bot, I guess, because this is going to be a fight. Nice. We got his flash, and he's dead. Zach's near bot lane. Sure, we have the tools available to get everyone out of that sticky wicket. Meanwhile, Orianna is wasting a bunch of her farm. Actually, she'll probably be able to make it back there, but if she doesn't, she's gonna lose this whole wave. Yeah, she's actually gonna end up losing this entire wave. We're gonna get top tower. Make sure everyone's aware of that. And I'll start running up towards my team because there's not really much for me to do. Nice! Wow, we really pushed that thing in. I'm having a pretty good game so far, truthfully. That could have gone better, admittedly, but I really wanted that blue buff. wave here from as far away as I can. Nice. And, oh, you know what? They're dedicating a lot of resources over here. I'm just going to go see if I can take this tower, because I am Ziggs. And I might actually be able to do it. I'm just going to see how much damage I can get onto this thing. I really do quite a bit of damage to towers. Might have to flash here. Actually, I'm not sure if he can chase me. Let's go in the other direction if he's gonna ult. Just walk it out towards the rest of the team. Pantheon, what are you thinking, buddy? You know I'm capable of changing directions. I'm sitting on way too much gold now, though. Okay, well, that went pretty well. I guess we just win. So that's... Sorry that I've had a kind of an abrupt end and was boring as fuck, but... Thank you all for joining me on this episode of Pajodcast Legends. See you all next time. Oh, oh, oh,